so many friends in the audience. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Let me see the world with clouds. Take me to the world. Out where I can push through crowds. Take me to the world. Just hold my hand and know I'm not alone. Take me to the world where I can be alive. We shall see the world come true. We shall have the world. I won't be afraid with you. We shall have the world with all around. Things growing in the ground where birds that make a sound are birds. We shall see the world come true. We shall have the world. I won't be afraid with you. We shall have the world. I'll hold your hand and know I'm not alone. We shall have the world to keep. Such a lovely world will weep. We shall have the world forever. Another 100 people just got off of the train and came up to the ground, while another 100 people just got off of the bus and are looking around at another 100 people who got off of the plane and are looking at us, who got off of the train and the plane and the bus maybe yesterday. It's a city of strangers. Some come to work, some to play. A city of strangers. Some come to stare, some to stay. And every day, the ones who stay can find each other in the crowded streets and the guarded parks, by the rusty fountains and the dusty trees with the battered barks. And they walk together past the postered walls with the crude remarks. And they meet at parties through the friends of friends who they never know. Will you pick me up or do I meet you there? Shall we let it go? Did you get my message? Cause I looked in vain. Can we see each other Tuesday if it doesn't rain? Look, I'll call you in the morning or I'll text you and explain. And another 100 people just got off of the train. And another 100 people just got off of the train and came up to the ground, while another 100 people just got off of the bus and are looking around at another 100 people who got off of the plane and are looking at us, who got off of the train and the plane and the bus maybe yesterday. It's a city of strangers. Some come to work, some to play. A city of strangers. Some come to stare, some to stay. And every day, the ones who stay can find each other in the crowded streets and the guarded parks, by the rusty fountains and the dusty trees with the battered barks. And they walk together past the postered walls with the crude remarks. And they meet at parties through the friends of friends who they never know. Will you pick me up or should I meet you there? Shall we let it go? Did you get my message? Cause I looked in vain. Can we see each other Tuesday if it doesn't rain? Look, I'll call you in the morning or I'll text you and explain. And another 100 people just got off of the train. And another 100 people just got off of the train. And another 100 people just got off of the train. And another 100 people just got off of the train. Another 100 people just got off of the train. evening, everyone. Thank you. Thank you for joining us on your Sunday evening. We're braving the snow and the weird winter weather, but I am so, so, so excited to be here. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Miles Mykkanen, and I am so honored to be sharing the stage tonight with my friend who we used to do programs like this on practically every nursing home and hospital on the Upper West Side when we were in college. And now, Adam, baby, here we are at Joe's Pub. Give it up for Adam Rothenberg. I also just want to take a moment at the top of the show to thank Young Arts for partnering tonight and helping bring Adam and I here to Joe's Pub. I won Young Arts when I was 18 years old, and this is a weird full circle moment in my life that Young Arts is now coming back into my life almost 15 years later, but the Botox is coming, you know. So I have friends, I have family here in the audience, and for those of you who don't know, I grew up in a very small town in Michigan, like 800 people small. I think I was the only gay boy there, but maybe not anymore. Adam, you've come a couple times, so you've upped the quota. and I was quite innocent, but then I moved to New York City when I was 18 years old, and it didn't take long for me to lose that innocence. It ain't so much a question of not knowing what to do. I know what's right and wrong since I've been 10. I heard a lot of stories, and I reckon they are true, about how boys are put upon by men. I know I mustn't fall into the pit, but when I'm with a feller, I forget. I'm just a boy who can't say no. I'm in a terrible fix. I always say, come on, let's go, just when I oughta say next. When a person tries to kiss a boy, I know I oughta give his face a smack. But as soon as someone kisses me, I somehow sorta wanna kiss him back. I'm just a fool when lights are low. I can't be prissy and quaint. I ain't the type that can faint. How could I be what I ain't? I can't say no. What you gonna do when a feller gets flirty and starts to talk purty? What you gonna do? Supposing that he says that your lips are like cherries or roses or berries. What you gonna do? Supposing that he says that you're sweeter than cream and he's gotta have cream or die. What you gonna do when he talks that way? Spit in his eye. I'm just a boy who can't say no, can't seem to say it at all. I hate to disappoint a beau when he is paying a call. For a while I act refined and cool, a sitting on a velveteen settee. Then I think of that old golden rule and do for him what he would do for me. I can't resist a Romeo in a sombrero and chaps. Soon as I sit on their lap, something inside of me snaps. I can't say no. Oh my gosh. So this is kind of crazy. In my very, very, very small town of 800 people, the sister of Lynn Riggs, who wrote the play Green Grows the Lilacs that Oklahoma's based on, I don't know why I'm still kind of in a southern accent. Excuse me, I gotta shake that off. but the sister of Lynn Riggs founded the community theater that I grew up in. And it's now the third oldest continually running community theater in the world. And it's this beautiful little piece of musical theater history right there in rural Michigan. But when I was 9 years old, I did my first title role in any show, and it was Oliver. But I had one break in Act Two, and I sat off stage, and there was this song that I just loved. And I didn't know why I loved it so much. But now, almost 25 years later, I know why. As long as he needs me, oh yes, he does need me, in spite of what you see, I'm sure that he needs me. Who else would love him still when they've been used so ill? He knows I always will, as long as he needs me. I miss him so much when he is gone, but when he's near me, I don't let on. The way I feel inside, the love I have to hide, the hell I've got, my pride. As long as he needs me, he doesn't say the things he should, he acts the way he thinks he should, but all the same I'll play this game. Steadfastly, as long as he needs me, as long as life is long, I'll love him right or wrong, and somehow I'll be strong, as long as he needs me. If you are lonely, then you will know when someone needs you, you love them so. Okay, now we're all warmed up here, right? It's time for some stories. Take a drink. Munich, 2019. I'm singing at the Bayerische Staatsoper. Covering Charlie Castronovo as Admet in Gluck's Alceste. Ever heard of it? Yeah, exactly. Is that Stephen Wadsworth, I think? And 2 days before I flew to Munich, I won the Metropolitan Opera National Council Auditions. The next day, hold on, I'm not done bragging. The next day, I won the Richard Tucker Foundation Sarah Tucker Award on Monday, and then on Tuesday, I flew to Munich for 3 months. That weekend, the day before I won the Metropolitan Opera auditions, my boyfriend at the time, who is a rather well-known opera singer, so I won't name his name, broke up with me. So here I am on a career high flying across the world singing at the Bayerische Staatsoper and utterly heartbroken. And for those of you that do know Alceste, you know that Admet is not in the first half of the opera. So the first few weeks in Munich were very light in my schedule. So I quickly found the English Ergotten and the nude section. Sorry, Mom, I know you're in the audience and you've never heard this story, but I would study my score every day in the English Ergotten and just get rid of my tan lines and have a lovely afternoon. And one day, as I'm paging through the score, I suddenly hear somebody say, Miles Mykkanen? And I looked up, you know, I'm naked. And he's naked. And I say, Yes, I am. He goes, I was just looking at the Bayerische Staatsoper's website and I recognized your headshot. And here you are, what are you doing? I said, well, I'm just studying the opera that I'm singing at the Bayerische Staatsoper. And anyway, his name was Pierre. Pierre, he was French, but in Munich for some reason. And we started talking and then we put our clothes on and went for a walk. And he takes me out for a drink. And then we stroll around charming Munich and the sun is going down. And we get to that moment in the evening where he turns to me and he goes, so do you want to come back to my place? And I said yes. And then he took a car beeper out, and suddenly the most beautiful BMW convertible sitting across the street was blinking. And I went, is that your car? And he said, yes, come out to my house in the country. So we did. And as we're zooming down the Autobahn, the tops were down, but the bottoms were up. The minute you walked in the joint, I could see you were a man of distinction, a real big spender. Good looking, so refined. Say, wouldn't you like to know what's going on in my mind? So let me get right to the point. I don't pop my cork for every man I see. Hey, big spender. Little time with me. Wouldn't you like to have fun, fun, fun? How's about a few laughs, laughs? I could show you a good time. Let me show you a good time. Now, remember that this story does take place in Munich. Steh nicht an der Tür, komm doch rein. Du bist ganz genau der Typ, den ich liebe. Ein halber Playboy, der jedes Herz zerbricht. Na komm schon ein bisschen näher, denn ich beiße dich nicht. Ich warte auf dich an der Bar. Kommen wir gleich zur Sache, Schätzchen, ohne Spaß. Hey, Big Spender! Hey, Big Spender!
spender. Boy, du bist ein Playboy nach Mars. Ah, Munich, ah, Munich. Never was a stay at home. I've wandered hill and valley with my two companions, Mr. Rand and Mr. McNally. Me, I like the traveling life. Yes, I like to get around. I found that the life for me is just to be so free and easy, easy and free, no matter where I chance to roam, where I hang my hat, that's home. I know the life for me is just to be so free and easy, easy and free, the traveling, the traveling, I love the traveling life. Pack your grip, come with me, and we will see Capri and be in Napoli for a weekend of fun. Plan your trip to Paris. There is a bistro on the left bank I like, 'cause it's frankly a place most tourists shun. Why not try the traveling life? You'll never want to settle down in town. Once you see it my way, hit the highway, every main road, every byway. The traveling life, that's the life for me. Yes, that's the life for me. Yes, that's the life for me.
A little Marvin Hamlish, written for the great Liza Minnelli. So, as you've all probably caught on, I spend about 300 days of the year on the road. But Adam, you live here in New York City. You're currently on the new production of Sweeney Todd.
Yeah. Yeah, it's been a blast. It's like one of my absolute dream scores, dream shows. So to get to do it here in New York on Broadway is the best. I'm so happy to be doing it.
You were on it with the original cast,
with
Annalee Ashford and Josh Groban. You saw them through rehearsals.
Yeah.
But now you're busy again.
Putting in a new cast. Yeah. Sutton Foster and Aaron Tveit coming down to the pie shop.
Yeah. But before that, you're kind of becoming the Sondheim guy here in New York City.
Which is the best thing ever. Sweeney Todd, my Broadway conducting debut was Company, the revival of that, starring your idol, Miles, Patti LuPone. And I'll share like one quick Patti story from it, because Miles needs a break for his voice.
But and I always need a Patti story.
We always love a Patti story.
Yeah.
In Company, in the song, The Little Things, it's this song early in the show, the first time that we hear Patti's character, Joanne, sing by herself. And you know, when you're conducting a show, there's not a whole lot of opportunity for live feedback as to whether or not it's going well. You kind of are sitting there and you're like, is this fast enough? I hope so. And you'll find out afterward if it was close to what it needed to be. But there was one opportunity with Patty for real-time, immediate feedback. And at the end of the song, Little Things, it ends with her singing, and on the button, she would slam a door. And we had to nail the button with her door slam every night. And if you didn't get it, it was very helpful. The sound mixer would leave her mic up. So often you and the rest of the audience would hear, not even close.
Like over the loudspeakers.
In the whole Bernard B. Jacobs Theater for everyone to hear. So I don't know what the final count was. I think I got not even close to maybe three times in the run of the show. But I will say one time I did get... Yeah, baby. And if that is the only success I have in this life, I will hold on to that forever.
You got a yeah, baby from Patti LuPone.
But speaking of company, you know, one of the most iconic songs from that show is Being Alive. And I think one of the most fascinating things about this genius, about Sondheim, we just kind of assume that everything he wrote was perfect as is the first time. And it turns out he was actually human too and had to do multiple drafts of things. And the song Being Alive is actually the third iteration of that song. The second one, Marry Me a Little, still stayed in the show and closes Act One. But the very, very first one is kind of lost in the history of musical theater. A lot of people don't know it. But this idea of fixation, you know, in Being Alive we hear... And this repeating figure is kind of indicating that this character is so stuck on something, right? So in this first draft, it's called Multitudes of Amys. And instead of, we get something different. It sounds like this.
Multitudes of Amys crowd the streets below. Avenues of Amy's, office fulls of Amy's, everywhere I go. Wonder what it means. Ho, ho, I wonder what it means. I see them waiting for the lights, running for the bus, milling in the stores and hailing cabs and disappearing through revolving doors. Multitudes of Amys, everywhere I look. Sentences of Amys, paragraphs of Amys, filling every book. Wonder if it means I've gone to pieces. Every other word I say is something she says. Walls hang with pictures of Amy's, galaxies of Amy's dot the night sky. Girls pass and look at me with Amy's eyes. I've seen an audience of Amy's, watch a cast of Amy's act in a play. Seems there are more of her every day. What can it mean? What can it mean? I've caught a stadium of Amy's standing up to cheer. Choruses of Amy's, symphonies of Amy's ringing in my ear. I know what it means. Hey, Amy, I know what it means. Oh, wow, I'm ready.
I'm ready. I'm ready now. Wonder what it means. Hey, Amy, I know what it means. So well, I'm ready. I'm ready. I'll say it. Marry me now.
I love when Adam calls me and he says, Miles, I've dug up a new Sondheim. We've got to do it on the next show. And that was the first time we've done that. And I hope it won't be the last. So, 1944, Kurt Weill, Ogden Nash, One Touch of Venus. Tell me, is love still a popular suggestion or merely an obsolete art? Forgive me for asking this simple question. I'm unfamiliar with his heart. I am a stranger here myself. Why is it wrong to murmur I adore him when it's shamefully obvious I do? Does love embarrass him, or does it bore him? I'm only waiting for my cue, since I'm a stranger here myself. I dream of a day, of a gay, warm day, with my face between his. Have I lost the path? Have I gone astray? I ask, and no one understands. Love me or leave me, that seems to be the question. I don't know the tactics to use. But if he should offer a personal suggestion, how could I possibly refuse, since I'm a stranger here myself? Please tell me, tell a stranger, my curiosity goaded. Is there really any danger that love should be outmoded? I'm interested especially in knowing why you waste it. True romance is so fleshly, with what have you replaced it? What is your latest foible? Is gin rummy more exquisite? Is skiing more enjoyable? For heaven's sakes, what is it? I can't believe that love has lost its glamour, that passion is really passé. If gender is just a term in grammar, how will I ever find my way, since I'm a stranger here myself? How can he ignore my available condition? Why these Victorian views? See here before you a boy on a mission. I must discover the key to his ignition. And then if he should make a diplomatic proposition, how could I possibly refuse? How could I possibly refuse? When I'm a stranger here myself. It's amazing. It's amazing. 80 years ago, that song was written, and it's still dirtier than ever. I mean, it's still... We don't even write things that dirty anymore. And it's just... Oh, I just love Weill. But speaking of music that we love, this next song is a piece that actually Adam and I have done in pretty much every single show we've ever done, with one exception. And
for many of you, I know you'll think of this as kind of one of the greatest Broadway anthems ever written, but for me, I've always felt that it's actually one of the most beautiful art songs written in the 20th century. And this is by the great Stephen Schwartz. Here is Meadowlark. When I was a boy, I had a favorite story of the meadowlark who lived where the rivers wind. Her voice could match the angels in its glory, but she was blind. The lark was blind. An old king came and took her to his palace, where the walls were burnished bronze and golden braid. And he fed her fruit and nuts from an ivory chalice. And he prayed, "Sing for me, my meadowlark, sing for me of the silver morning. Set me free, my meadowlark, and I'll buy you a priceless jewel, cloth of brocade and crewel, and I'll love you for life if you will sing for me." Then one day, as the lark sang by the water, the god of the sun heard her in his flight. And her singing moved him, so he came and brought her the gift of sight. He gave her sight, and she opened her eyes to the shimmer and the splendor of this beautiful young god, so proud and strong. And he called to the lark in a voice both rough and tender, "Come along, fly with me, my meadowlark, fly with me on the silver morning, past the sea where the dolphins bark. We will dance on the coral beaches, make a feast of the plums and peaches, just as far as your vision reaches. Fly with me." But the meadowlark said no, for the old king loved her so, she couldn't bear to wound his pride. So the sun god flew away, and when the king came down that day, he found his meadowlark had died. Every time I heard that part, I cried. And now I stand here, starry-eyed and stormy. Oh, just when I thought my heart was finally numb, a beautiful young man appears before me, saying, "Come, oh, won't you come? And what can I do if finally, for the first time, the one I'm burning for returns the glow? If love has come at last, it's picked the worst time. Still, I know I've got to go. Fly away, meadowlark, fly away of the silver morning. If I stay, I'll grow to curse the dark. So it's off where the days don't bind me. I know I leave wounds behind me, but I won't let tomorrow find me back this way. Before my past once again can blind me, fly away." To say goodbye, my beautiful young man.
Isn't that a stunning song? I love singing it. Every time we practice, I'm like, nope, Adam, we're not skipping Meadowlark. I just want to sing it again. most everyone in this room, I'm starting to recognize all the faces now. You all probably know that I really kind of launched my career with Candide. And I ended up singing over 60 performances in, if you count up all of the concert versions and full productions, because every single production of Candide is different with a different book, I did 13 productions of Candide around the world. And a year ago, I retired Candide. I only say that because no one hires me for Candide anymore. It's just the classy way to say that I'm not getting hired. I retired Candide. Don't worry. If somebody wants to hire me for it, I'll do it. But, you know, Candides normally graduate into the governor or Vanderdender, one of the other tenor roles. But you know what? I'm going to declare it here right now at Joe's Pub here on January 7th, 2024. I want to graduate to the role of the old lady. I was not born in sunny Hispania. My mother came from Rovno Gubernia. But now I'm here, I'm dancing a tango. Di-di-di, di-di-di, I am easily assimilated. I am so easily assimilated. I never learned a human language. My mother spoke a high middle Polish. In 1/2 hour, I'm talking in Spanish. Por favor, Toreador, I am easily assimilated. I am so easily assimilated. And I didn't rip my pants. It's easy. It's ever so easy. I'm Spanish. I'm suddenly Spanish. And you must be Spanish to do like the natives do. These days you have to be in the majority. Tus labios rubí, dos rosas que se abren a mí. Conquista mi corazón y solo con una canción. Mis labios rubí, tus rosas que se abren a mí. Conquista mi corazón y solo con una divina canción. Me muero, me sale una hernia. A long way from Rovno Gubernia. Mis labios rubí, dos rosas que se abren a mí. Conquista mi corazón y solo con una divina canción de tus labios rubí. Rubí. Take it away, baby. Thank you.
mis labios rubí, dos rosas que se abren a mí, con lisa mi corazón y solo con una divina canción de tus labios rubí.
Of the night here, Adam. Oh my God. No. Adam, bravo. Bravo. And we only came up with that on Friday to do this interlude, and Adam's like, oh, I'll make something up. Okay. Let me just take a quick breather and pull my pants back up. Okay. Too much lunging. Okay. And now, for a moment from my actual day job.
I had to mix it up from the Pearl Fisher's aria for those of you that see all my shows, you know. Well, it is that unfortunate time of the night where we have to start wrapping up. But first, I know. But, you know, applaud and we have an encore or two, maybe, I don't know. We could figure something out. No, but listen, you all are my friends, my family, my teachers, my mentors. Tonight meant a lot to me. I grew up doing cabarets. Before I ever got into opera, I used to sing with my dad at that theater that I told you about earlier, and we would put on the Miles shows. And then I ended up falling into opera and figuring out how to sing high notes and make it pretty with Cynthia's help. And now it's just this weird full circle moment that I have Adam in my life and that we get to do all of these shows together. So first of all, everyone, please give it up for my orchestra tonight, Adam Rothenberg. You know, be big spenders tonight and make sure you take care of the wonderful staff and servers here at Joe's Pub. Thank you for taking such good care of us, for everyone here at the public and Joe's Pub. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And finally, I want to thank all of you for coming. We're a week into 2024. There's a lot of shit happening in the world, but it's nights like this that remind me that there is good, there is positive things coming. We have to believe that. And my resolution this year, the only resolution I set for myself, was just to make 2024 a happy, happy new year. So that is my wish for all of you. I hope you have a very, very, very happy trip around the sun over these next 12 months. And just sing me a happy song about robins in spring. Sing me a happy song with a happy ending. Some cheerful rondelay about catching the ring. Sing happy. Sing me a sonnet all about rolling in gold, or some peppy melody about rainbows blending. Nothing with phrases saying you're out in the cold. Sing happy. Tell me tomorrow's gonna be peaches and cream. Assure me clouds are lined with a silver lining. Say how you realize an impossible dream. Sing me a happy song. Play me a madrigal about trips to the moon, or some old ballad all about two eyes shining. It can't be loud enough for a moment too soon. Sing happy. No need reminding me how it all fell apart. I need no lyrics singing of stormy weather. There's quite enough around me that's breaking my heart. Sing happy. Give me a hallelujah and get up and shout. Assure me clouds are lined with a silver lining. Whoever's interested in helping me out, please keep it happy. I'm
market for long, loud laughter. I'll let you serenade me till dawn comes along. Just make it a happy, keep it a happy.
I'll save the running on and off. We'll just. I 10 years ago this month, I made my Carnegie Hall recital debut, and I finished it with this number. It's going back to my Scandinavian heritage. Often we hear this song sung in German, but tonight I'd like to sing it in Norwegian for you. And this song is about two lovers. Dreaming, they're in a dream together underneath the tree and taking in the sunlight, and they're just wishing, wishing, wishing that the day won't end. And tonight my wish, of course, is that this evening won't end. So thank you for joining us.